Welcome back. She's on the growing list of best-selling authors who live in Northeast Ohio, writing not though her first career. DM Pulley joining us this morning, sharing a little bit about her new book, which is based in Shaker Heights. It's called No One's Home. Here it is right there. Thank you for bringing it in. Good morning to you. And welcome back. You were here a few years ago.
I was.
With your first book that you wrote, The Dead Key.
That's correct. Yeah. It's a thrill to be back.
And you won the Amazon Award for that.
I did. Yeah. I won this big contest that launched my career from being an engineer to becoming a full-time writer, which is bizarre, but who knew? Life is strange.
It's such an odd, you wouldn't expect somebody who's a structural engineer to be an author as well, but you know, you write reports all the time and you've been writing for a long time just as you went through school.
Yeah, in fact, I actually applied to journalism school. Yeah. I got accepted at Northwestern, and finances and fate just stepped in and I ended up in Cleveland at Case Western studying engineering on scholarship, and it all worked out beautifully because as a writer, the more life experience you have and the more in-depth knowledge you have about something that people are curious about, the better off you are. So,
which is great when you bring in like haunted house and haunted buildings and stuff like that, because it's so key in people's minds. They love to watch the shows, they love to read the books about this, and now you have another one set in Shaker Heights.
Yes.
About a mansion. And is this a place that you know, or kind of something you came up with?
Well, actually, it was inspired by many houses. I live in Shaker in a house that's 100 years old.
Okay.
And as an engineer, I did home renovations for houses in Lakewood, Cleveland Heights, and Shaker Heights, doing bathrooms and kitchens.
Yeah.
And in tearing apart houses for a few years, I found all kinds of interesting things in the walls of the buildings, including a little boy's shoe.
Really?
That makes an appearance in this story. Also, house hunting in Shaker. I went through over 60 beautiful old homes, including a house that was gorgeous, but it had fallen on hard times. It was foreclosed, and it had the copper pipes ripped out, and graffiti was everywhere. And the story of the family that had lived there was circulating around the open house about how the husband had died and the mother had sort of fell apart, and the daughter had fallen on hard times and had begun stealing things from the house. And there was paint on the windows and graffiti and evidence of even a potential crime. There was bloodstains on the floor. And this house, I didn't buy it.
Yeah.
But part of me really wanted to. It was this beautiful 4,000 square foot Tudor. It was gorgeous. And I love the idea of telling a story of a family who did buy that house.
Mm-hmm.
And the interesting and crazy stories they uncovered while living there.
Well, a great inspiration, too. And of course, your background is structural engineer. Mm-hmm. You're able to talk about the house specifically. And what you see and what you imagine, you immediately can transfer that to paper. It was amazing.
It's
so descriptive in the book of just the way you describe things. It's very cool, and I got to give you credit for that.
I appreciate that.
As a best-selling author, I'm sure that helps, you know? So let's talk about the Historical Society, because you're going to do a signing there, and you want to help out the Historical Society. And obviously, as an engineer who goes through these houses, you have an appreciation for that, too.
Oh, absolutely. The Shaker Heights Historical Society was a huge help to me when I was researching the history of the Shakers, which plays a part in this story because, you know, where all of our homes sit on ground that was something else once before.
Right.
Other people lived there. And the history of the Shakers was fascinating. And the archives at the Historical Society were really helpful in me understanding their rituals and some of their bizarre mysticism.
Really?
Oh, they believed they could speak to angels when they were dancing outside on this circle of trees that they called the Holy Grove. And so I found all these interesting tidbits that most people aren't aware of about the Shakers through this society. And they also celebrate the Van Swearingen brothers, who founded and built Shaker Heights. And so this historical society has been around since, you know, gosh, I think the 1920s.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, 1909, they moved some of the graves of the Shakers to a graveyard near the Heinens at Lee and Chagrin.
Yeah.
And there's a plaque from the Shaker Historical Society. They have maintained landmarks all over Shaker Heights. And today, Saturday's book signing there will partly benefit the society. New members, if you sign up to be a member of the Shaker Heights Historical Society, if you go to this event, you'll get a free book.
Mm-hmm.
The great news is the event sold out.
That's awesome.
Standing room only if you're wanting to stop by and take a tour of a beautiful mansion, the Myers House, that was donated to the society in the 60s. It's a great example of the sort of house that inspired the story.
That is awesome. The book signing is this Saturday, September 7th. It's from 1 p.m. to 3:30, again, at the Shaker Historical Museum. If you become a new member, you can get the free book.
Yes, first 20.
For a complete list, because you're going to be at a bunch of different places around East and West Side, too. Fox8.com if you want to take a look at that. DM, thanks so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
And congrats on the new book.
Thanks, I'm excited.
Is it four books now total?
This is my fourth, yeah.
That's awesome.
Thank you so much.
Keep them coming. Keep coming to Fox 8 to talk about